I'm Brian Vance, sportbiketracker.com, and today we're going to install a pair, man, I'm really pumped to do this too, a pair of the LighTech R version rear sets on our 2018 Suzuki GSX-R1000R project bike. Okay, we've done LighTech part installs previously, okay? LighTech is absolutely a premium Italian brand in aftermarket sport bike parts. Phenomenal quality, unbelievable tolerances. You see the stuff used, World Superbike, places like that. I want you to think very high end. Their rear sets are available in multiple versions. The one we're gonna show you here is the top rung of their rear set kits. This is the R version. Bitchin' black and red carbon heel guards, this folding foot pegs, folding toe pieces, uses their track system. Foot peg adjustment is very easy. It's all done using this 10 mil right here, all external. The adjustment for the toe piece right here, that's a 4 mil internal hex slide system there. Amazing, the quality, the fit, the tolerances, like even the way this fits through the brake master cylinder clevis for the rear brake. Notice the up and down play, that's it. It's almost none, okay? Even the wobble in the pedal itself, I mean, that's tighter than the OEM stuff. The quality is amazing. They installed really easy. They fit exactly as I would have expected them to. Pros and cons, I do this again at the end of the video. I'll hit it real quick right now. The only con I've got for you is this is a big investment of money, okay? If you go with the R version, you're spending big jack. If you're building a super bike, something you're really proud of, kind of a show bike, you want a lot of badass exotic stuff on it, this for sure is a great option. You will not be disappointed. You're not going to open up the box and go, wait, these things aren't that great. No, you're going to open up the box and you're going to be absolutely blown away. Your wallet's going to be a little bit light, but if you're comfortable with that part, you're going to love these rear sets on your bike. Let's go over to the shift side real quick and just show you what they did on the GSX-R1000. Standard RGP shift, okay? There's a little additional adjustment here. You're able to keep the shift rod itself perpendicular. There's a slide system here, similar to what you're seeing here with the toe pieces, okay? Folding toe, God, those things are gorgeous. Really dug that. Once again, the play here, the end result, I mean, look at that, how tight that tolerance is. Of course, it's all bearing. Any play that you see here right now, that is just gonna be, you know, in the actual, the shift shaft itself. I mean, that's not from the rear sets. That's as tight as it can possibly be. Very easy install over here, easy adjustment. If you like what you see so far, stay tuned. I'm gonna run you through the entire installation. Okay, let's jump right into the install. There's a couple of pieces here that came pre-assembled from LighTech. Just wanna double check the torque on those. That feels good. Bracket here for the rear master. Gorgeous fasteners here. Okay, there was a snap ring that was on here that is used to retain the clevis for the rear brake master cylinder. I removed the snap ring, it's right here. Okay, a little pair of snap ring pliers I'm gonna use there to reinstall that. Okay, got a little bit of just all-purpose grease here, just gonna lubricate the pivot for that brake clevis, like so. We're gonna use the washer, the OEM washer, when we install this. So for now, let's slide that through. Put the washer on. Now we'll grab our snap ring. A little different, you know, we're used to reusing the OEM pin with the OEM cotter key, right? And this is totally different here. Pretty high-end stuff. Spread that apart. Make sure you get that all the way over. Heard that kind of click on, and now you can see you can rotate it around. One comment here is, man, that's a pretty tight tolerance with that rear brake clevis. That's a little bit unique. Don't normally see it that tight. Typically, there's a lot of free play there. Now we're ready to bolt the bracket to the frame of the motorcycle. Okay, now to mount the bracket to the frame of the motorcycle, we're going to reuse the stock fasteners. Do you want to use a little bit of thread locker here? We're just going to use some medium. This is the gel type stuff right here. Okay, the machining on this stuff is just gorgeous. Started. This would be the first time I've ever installed a pair of LighTech rear sets. We've used some of their performance parts on various bikes over the years. Never have used a rear set kit. This would be the first time. And I have to admit, what I see so far is pretty damn impressive. Okay, we'll get those both run down. Go ahead and torque these now. Make sure they're nice and even. Now mounting the rear brake master. That bolts up right here. They supply two fasteners for that. Of course, we're going to put a little medium thread locker on these as well. It's normal to feel a little tension here. You've got the brake line, and on our project bike, we have a stainless steel speakler brake line. These things can be kind of firm, so I'm going to feel a little pressure. Get both of these seated, then we can torque them down. We're heading to Grattan Raceway again this weekend with Sportbike Track Time. Max and I are going. Jimmy's going. Corey's going. John's going. A lot of staff, so I get a chance to ride these right out of the gate. Pretty excited about that. Okay, we've got both of those torqued. Now we have the heel guard. On this particular bike, there are two different length fasteners we need to use. Okay, the longer of the two is going to be at the front edge of the heel guard. The shorter goes at the back. Look at this thing. God, that is just absolutely gorgeous. Put a little, just a little bit of thread locker on these. Definitely don't want these coming loose and losing that carbon heel guard. I think it's pretty sexy. Okay, let's get that in position. This is going really smoothly. Oftentimes the brake side's the more difficult, and on this bike, this is just flying right on there. You're gonna wanna watch your torque here. There's no reason to apply a ridiculous amount of torque. Okay, you wanna crack the carbon. That's why we do have the thread locker on there as well. It's gonna hold it in place. Okay, now it's time to put the foot peg onto the main bracket. First thing we're going to do is double check this fastener, make sure it's tight. It was in there from the factory. It is. These are the folding foot pegs. All right, pretty cool. You're able to install this in either the top or the bottom slot. It slides back and forth, and you can see the range of adjustment there. As you're going back, you're also raising up a little bit. Okay, you can also use it here on the top. Plenty of adjustment, super easy to do. I have a pretty fair idea of where I want to be. It's right about here. Once I establish a final spot for these foot pegs, I will then pull this back apart and we're going to use thread locker on it. But for right now, I don't know where that's going to be. I want to ride the bike first. So we will not use thread locker on our initial install. Just make sure it's torqued nice and evenly, okay? God, that's just super sexy. And then we also have the toe piece here, folding toe piece for the brake pedal. Need to snug this up. And once again, we gotta put on the boots that I'm gonna ride in, get on the bike, and get this all dialed in using the footwear you would normally ride in. This is a good beginning point. We'll do that, and then we'll ride it. Okay, now we're over on the shift side. This typically goes a little easier. We have our OEM shift pedal bracket is still mounted to the bike, okay? Here is the shift pedal from LighTech. The fasteners you're gonna use to mount this to the OE bracket. As such, okay, you got a spacer here on the back side. You can see the adjustment of the toe piece. Once again, folding toe piece. The actual shift rod itself, it does come with a shift rod if you have a standard model. We've got an R model here that has the shift sensor, so we won't be using this rod. Okay, we're gonna be reusing our stock rod. It includes a heim joint, fastener for the heim joint. Now go ahead and put the spacer on the back side of the heim joint. That slides through that slot like so. And then you have a nut that goes on the back side. And this is pretty unique too. The nut actually fits in this slot. So it holds it, it's captured. You don't need a backup wrench for that. So when you go to tighten that down, it's held firmly in place. And what's really bitching about this is you're able to slide this back and forth. And this is gonna make a lot of sense once we have this on the bike so you can get the perfect location for the shift rod, right? Really dig that, looks super cool. Got your footrest, just like we showed you over on the brake side. Same foot peg design. And of course we have the carbon heel guard. Okay, I'm gonna start by threading the heim joint into my stock shift rod. And I wanna, you know, kind of mimic what I've got going on here, leave some threads for adjustment. Okay, that looks like a great place to start. From here, we're gonna go ahead and put the fastener through the heim joint. The spacer between the heim joint and the shift pedal, like so. Now we've got the nut. Remember, the nut needs to ride inside that groove. Okay. That is a locking nut, so there's, realistically, in my opinion, there's no need for thread locker here because that's a nylock nut. It's got mechanical locking properties to it. You can kind of see that right there. Okay, no need for thread locker there, that would just be redundant. This, on the other hand, you don't want this one falling out, so we're gonna put some thread locker on here. We're gonna stick with just the blue, medium strength. Pass that through. Spacer, like so. Put down here, get that started. Make sure you've got the shift pedal on the shoulder of that bolt. 6mm internal hex. Torque that down. Like so. Okay, we're gonna leave that loose for right now. Let's get some thread locker on the main mounting bolts. For the footrest bracket. Get that up into position. We'll run these each down. just until they're seated, finger tight, and then we'll torque them both evenly. So, now onto the heel guard. Once again, just a little bit of thread locker here. And we'll grab our T-handle. The heel guard into position. Started. Nice even torque, and once again, you don't need to go crazy here. Small fasteners, tapered seat, carbon fiber, just enough to get them snug so the thread locker can dry and hold it in place. Now we have our toe piece, our foot peg bracket. We do want to double check that fastener. It came installed from LighTech. Feels good. Even this, look at that, nice tapered seat fastener, okay? You have a lot of mechanical grip with that. Get it in the same position that we had on the brake side. Right there. Torque down. Once again, we will use some thread locker there once we've landed on our final point of adjustment. I really need to ride the bike in order to do that. Now let's talk about adjustment for our shifter here. There's a length adjustment here, okay? And also, if you see here, that slot down here, look at what I'm able to do with that shift rod. You want to make sure you've got good clearance here between the frame and that shift sensor. It's really important, and this allows you to achieve that, okay? I've got a locking nut on the other side. And you realistically want to aim for straight up and down, perpendicular to the ground as possible. Put some torque to that. So, still need to tighten the jam nut there. And then, of course, we have our toe piece here. And look at all the adjustment. I'm going to start here. Torque that. Looks like a reasonable place to start here. So, we can go ahead and snug up that jam nut. Notice how I'm rocking this back and forth. Anytime you're doing rear sets, there's a few things that you really want to aim for, okay? You want to have these angles as close to 90 degrees as humanly possible, okay? That's one thing, and that's in a good position there. You're not going to lose any mechanical advantage. Try and get this perpendicular to the floor. On this case, you're able to do that with that slot they provide there in the shift lever, okay? Also, your hind joints, you want to make sure that they're both on the same plane so you don't have any binding, okay? A great way to determine if you've done that or not is by rotating that lever, right? That shift rod back and forth like that. You can see both the heim joints have plenty of mobility in them. There's no binding whatsoever. And your end result here, right? There is no additional play from the rear sets. You know, any play that you have in here right now is what's already part of the shift shaft from the bike. So this should be nice, accurate, clean shifting. Okay, that completes the install itself. Like I said, it's really important. before you go ride the bike. Whatever riding shoes or boots you're gonna wear, get those on, jump on the bike, and feel the controls, the position they're at, and take that time to dial them in. So the first ride, you're gonna be relatively close. And from there, fine tune it. If you're at the racetrack after your first session or two, make those finite adjustments. What do I like about this kit, right? Let's go pros and cons. Let's open up with the cons. The first one is gonna be the cost. This R version, let's face it, it's really expensive, okay? Are they worth the money? The machining quality is amazing. The feel, right, the tight tolerances, all those things, yeah, it's amazing. If your budget allows for it and you're building a high-end motorcycle and you want parts like this on it, I don't think you're gonna be disappointed when you invest the money. Just understand up front, I mean, it's a big investment. They do also offer another version of the rear sets, not the R's. They share a lot of things in common. There are some finer points, some refinements with the R version, but you can still get very, very close to this with a much more reasonable spend. So that would be the con, the cost. The pros, the tight tolerances, the adjustability. I mean, like, it just shows some of this. Like, let's say that, you know, you want to shorten up that brake pedal. I mean, you can make these adjustments at the track, in your garage, with ease. That's just a 4T handle. Let's say your foot peg position, you're just like, man, I really wanna change that. You know, I wanna go into the track, I wanna get him up in a higher position, okay? Literally, just pick your spot. That's a 10 mil socket on a T handle, right? Snug it up, you're good to go. The folding pegs are an option, they're spring loaded. They're pretty badass. The pegs, a lot of traction. Even these little toe pieces, the rubber cover over it, the folding toe piece, super bitchin'. Let's go over to the shift side. Take a quick look at that. On the shift side of this motorcycle, same thing with the foot pegs. The adjustments, super easy. The shifter adjustments, also very easy. You can still adjust up and down using the length of the shift rod itself, okay? I'm sure you're familiar with how to do that already. Something else that struck me, you know, it's just the tight tolerance overall. I mean, that is just really, just realistically no play in the rear set shift pedal itself. Any play would be in the motorcycle, okay? And that's minor stuff. Some of that is gonna be the shift sensor. Also impressive was this slot that they have here. You're able to loosen that, slide it back and forth to really dial that position to make sure you got good clearance and you're as perpendicular as humanly possible. That's all mechanical advantage stuff, right? Impressive. The carbon heel guards on the R version, I mean, those are just absolutely gorgeous. GP shift or standard shift, this will work either way. This also fits the standard version of the GSX-R 1000 or the GSX-R 1000R. Awesome parts. They will not disappoint if you invest in them. Once again, the con is going to be the price. That's it. I'm Brian Vann, sportbiketrackgear.com.